The next topic we're looking at is the polygon triangulation. This step is a fundamental pre-processing step in many algorithms. So the problem is the following. We have given a simple polygon with n vertices and n edges, and we want to decompose it into a bunch of triangles. Note that this decomposition into triangles is not necessarily unique. So for example, this polygon can have the following decomposition. And by decomposition, we actually mean that we connect some of these vertices such that the segment that connects the vertices goes through the polygon, so it lies inside, and such that the interior of the polygon is decomposed into a bunch of triangles. So this is, for example, one possible decomposition of this polygon into triangles. This is another one. This is another one. So this this decomposition is not unique at all. But what we want to avoid is to connect two vertices such that the connection goes outside. So this is not allowed. So we cannot do this. And that's a problem we want to solve. So given a polygon with n vertices, how can we decompose this into triangles? And again, the reason we want to do this is because it's much easier to treat a polygon as a collection of triangles rather than just an object with very complex structure. Many problems become much easier once we can do this decomposition of a polygon into triangles. So again, going back to the problem, we have a simple polygon. What this means is that the boundary of the polygon is connected, and it also does not have self-intersection. So in particular, means that we don't have a picture that looks like this or like this. So this polygon, the boundary is self-intersection, so these two edges of the polygon intersect, so that's not allowed. And in this picture, we have a hole inside the polygon, so this part is not, it's part of the outside, it's not part of the inside. And we want to show that, so before going to the algorithm, we want to show that triangulation of a polygon is always possible. Okay, and something about how we want to preserve the output. So typically, we want this decomposition to be stored in a doubly connected edge list. Sometimes it's enough to just output a list of triangles, but for a lot of applications, we want to store the decomposition using doubly connected edge list. What this means that if I, for example, go to this picture, is that you set up the correct pointers from every triangle to all the other nearby triangles. So for example, the edges of this triangle would be directed in the clockwise order in this sense. Every edge will have again two copies, and etc. etc. So you set up all the pointers that I talk about in the doubly connected edge list video. And that's a problem I want to solve. But of course, before doing that, I want to show a bunch of results, theoretical results, showing that these things are always possible, as well as some basics. And I'm going to do that in the next video.